Now then, he's sold millions of records, so he's not alone there, really. He's won the hearts of millions of women around the world.
And he's not alone there, really.
But he did wear some very dodgy flares at one time, didn't he?
He's not alone there either, yeah.
But he is a singing legend.
He's sort of alone there, yeah.
It's Neil Diamond, and he's definitely alone. He's very unique, and he's back with a new CD, and he's been talking exclusively, no less, to Helen Morton in New York about life as a superstar.
My baby's crying on a Saturday night. She thinks that nothing's ever gonna go right. But she'll make it, and we'll make it. There's no way that I'm leaving the best part of me.
Well, it's lovely to meet you.
My pleasure, Helen.
Congratulations on your new album. Now, this is
the first one
that you've completely written everything on, isn't it? Songs and music.
For a long time.
For a quarter of a century.
That's right.
Tell me a bit about it.
Well, I think it's a very personal album. It tells the story in songs of the average person, the aspirations of these people, the joys and the frustrations as well. All of these situations in this album are shared by pretty much all of us. Regrets from the past and hopes for the future, really.
I want you to know what I've always known. You're the best part of me.
You said in the past, I think, that if you know your music, then somebody knows you. Do you ever feel in, oh my goodness, I've laid myself a bit too open there?
You do lay yourself bare when you're creating something. There's no way to get around it, but in order to do something wonderful, I think you have to open yourself up. So I opened myself as much as I possibly could, and was able to come up with these songs that express that openness and really all of my reflections and internal workings at this point in my life.
How have you handled the fame side? Is that something you enjoy, or is that a side that you don't particularly enjoy, but it's a natural part of being a successful artist?
I guess it has its pluses. I mean, you can get tickets to a show pretty quickly, and you might get into a restaurant a little more easily than someone else, but there's a heavy price that you have to pay. And I've come to prize my privacy because it is so fleeting and so elusive in my life now. A few days ago, I was walking down the street in New York, and there was a bum, a vagrant on the street, and he was just sitting there, and he was just a poor soul. And I went over and I dropped a dollar in his hat, and he looked up at me and he said, "Neil Diamond." And I was absolutely shocked. I mean, the man was just barely able to comprehend things, and yet he recognized me. And when he called out my name, a group of people came over to check it out to see if it was Neil Diamond. And I think that's the biggest price you pay, where so many people know you.
Again, hello.
But it's a beautiful night. Never in blue jeans, September morn.
How did you know that you wanted to be a singer-songwriter?
Well, I can't honestly say that I did know. Kids from the inner city would go to camp in the country for 3 weeks every summer, and it was wonderful. It took me off the streets of New York, put me into the countryside. Trees and grass and hiking and bonfires and playing guitars and singing with my new friends.
What a beautiful noise.
When I got back after my first year, I started leaving hints for my parents that maybe I could take some music lessons. And for my birthday, they did give me a guitar. And I started to learn very quickly how to play the thing, and I practiced diligently. Nobody had to force me. I just fell in love with it immediately. And I was kind of amazed and taken by this ability, I think, that I had that I never knew I had.
When it's a beautiful noise, and it's a sound that I love, and it makes me feel good, just like a hand in a glove.
Yes, it does. Yes, it does.
Throughout college, which was right here at New York University and in the heart of Greenwich Village, which was a hotbed of music at that time, I was just happy to be there, to be among these other kids. And some of them were brilliantly talented, and they taught me a great deal. And I just continued from that point and until today.
Have those sacrifices been worth it for you when you look back at your career?
I think so. But I'm not certain. I gave up two marriages. I gave up the growing up of my four children. I was only able to see them at very special times. But I adored them, and I still do, and we have a super close relationship still. They've kept me grounded. And without them, there would have been no reason for me to pursue this thing so far.
Cause if you get hurt, sometimes you'll never be healed. So just count me in this mission of love.